Johnson Learning Leopards and Families. It's Miss Coleman. Miss Robertson and I are going to do the Roar Rap with you. Miss Robertson is going to lead us and you can follow along with me.
All right, guys, here we go. Let's start our clap. Hey, Learning Leopards, what do you say? Let's all do some roaring today. R, O, A, R, your turn.
R, O, A, R.
When I say Johnson, you say roars. Johnson.
Roars.
Johnson.
Roars.
When I say Johnson, you say roars. Johnson.
Roars.
Johnson.
Roars.
Now let's review, just to be sure, repeat after me, how we roar. R is respectful.
R is respectful.
O is open-minded.
O is open-minded.
A is actively engaged.
A is actively engaged.
And R is responsible.
R is responsible.
We are Johnson.
We are Johnson.
Hear us roar.
Hear us roar.
Woo!
The January birthdays in pre-K are Dylan, Pamela, and Halima. Happy birthday, pre-K. In kindergarten, we have Ruthie, Samir, Malia, Winter, and Hikma. Happy birthday, kinders.
In first grade, we have Isabel, Mariama, and Cliff. Happy birthday, first graders.
In second grade, we have Fatima, Ali, Hatcher, and Carlise. Happy birthday, second graders.
And we have no third grade birthdays, but in fourth grade, we have Jaden, Jed, Jeremiah, Jamarion, and JW. Happy birthday, fourth graders. And staff birthdays, we have Miss Dunlap and Mr. Hughes. Happy birthday.
Welcome to the January school-wide morning meeting. Miss Robertson here, and I am going to do a read aloud. This is a book that Miss Flowers loaned me from the library. So if you enjoy the parts that I'm going to share with you, you should ask her about checking it out, and you can read the rest of the poems that I'm not going to get to read to you this morning. This book is called Every Month is a New Year. And the illustrations are beautiful. The author is Marilyn Singer, and the illustrator is Susan Roth. And you'll notice when we open the book that all the illustrations are collages. So make sure you notice that as we're reading. And this book is a collection of poems all about different traditions and cultures and when they celebrate the new year. So for most of us, we celebrated the new year on January 1st. But in other parts of the world and in other cultures, they celebrate the new year at various points throughout the year. And we're going to read about a few of them. And if you're interested, there are even more to learn about in this book that you could check out from the library. The year turns. We choose the date from the Earth's movement, from the moon's phases, these clocks and calendars we create. Together, in parks and squares, in temples and houses, watching the year turn, we celebrate. December, midnight ball drop. This one will probably be pretty familiar to most of you. New Year's Eve, celebrated in New York City in the United States. Tonight, hand in hand with Grandma, I stand in the middle of this merry, loud crowd waiting for that glittering ball to drop at the magic hour, bringing on a confetti shower. Over Times Square, my friends may say they saw it on TV, but I can brag that I was there. February, Dragon Dance, the Chinese New Year, often celebrated in Hong Kong, China. Today, my shy brother has become part red dragon, dancing joyfully in the square, whipping his tail to the beat of the drum, chasing away the evil spirits, bringing health, wealth, joy. Gong Hei Fa Choi, I cry as he passes by. Later at our family feast, we will have dumplings, oranges, long noodles, and more. And my shy brother, who had been part glorious beast, will not give the smallest roar. September. Daisies. Inkutatash. Often celebrated in Ethiopia. Many years ago, the Queen of Sheba gave gold to King Solomon. When she returned from Jerusalem, she was welcomed home with jewels. So too did sun and sky celebrate her return with glorious spring. Now, in fields golden with daisies, I will sing of this beautiful land. I will gather a bouquet to give you on this shining New Year's Day. Give me back a smile. We will all be kings and queens on Inkutatash. October, casting away sins, Rosh Hashanah, often celebrated in the United States. This morning in the synagogue, we heard the shofar's loud, clear sound. This evening in the house, we'll have apples dipped in honey, pomegranates with their ruby seeds. But now, this sunny afternoon, we will walk to the creek, our pockets full of bread. I'll tell you the truth, I lost the money, my big sister whispers. I'll tell you the truth, I tore the dress, I whisper back. Then we toss the bread and our sins and watch the flowing water carry them far, far away. November, Festival of Lights, Diwali, India. On Diwali, no one can make sweets like Daddy. Milky soft, scented like roses. No one can make Rangoli like Ma. Swirls of colored rice become lotuses on the floor. No one can sing songs like Nani or dance like Nana. And no one can light every corner of our house with our dazzling diyas like my sister and me. Or shout louder, waving our sparklers in the smoky air as firecrackers bang and comet rockets shoot toward the sky, chasing away demons lurking in the dark. On this festival of lights, we are beginning again. Shiny, busy, and noisy with hope. Turning the year. Celebrate! We turn the year, watching in temples and houses, in parks and squares. Together we create these clocks and calendars from the moon's phases, from the earth's movement. We choose the date.
Hey everyone, it's time for our game this morning. We're going to be playing snowball basketball, where players are going to be given a bin of snowballs, and they have to stand behind a line and shoot their snowballs into a bucket in 10 seconds. And whoever has the most snowballs in their bucket after 10 seconds is our winner. Now, it's not as easy as you may think it is, because since there's been no snow so far this school year, we had to improvise. And instead of using real snowballs, we had to make paper snowballs, and the paper's kind of light. So I'm excited to see how many we can get. So I'm gonna go get our players and let's go get started.
All right, so here are our participants for our snowball basketball game. In kindergarten, we have?
Polly.
In first grade, we have?
Jalan.
In second grade, we have?
Deborah.
In third grade, we have?
Tejon.
And in fourth grade, we have?
JW.
Go, Polly, go, Polly!
So Polly got four. Good job.
Nice job, Polly.
Day, and we need to celebrate.
Now it's time to celebrate, to celebrate.
Celebrate.
Now it's time to celebrate, to celebrate.
You gotta turn it up.
Yo, that's so great. Let's not wait, let's celebrate. Undulate, move your vertebrae. Party activate, be a good time advocate. Move your body as we celebrate. And animate, congregate, culminate, demonstrate. Dance on down to the bare and straight. But there's one thing left to extrapolate. So come on, party people, let me hear you say.
Come on.
Celebrate, celebrate,
celebrate.
Now
Don't we meditate or procrastinate? Let's appreciate, let's celebrate. Undulate, move your vertebrae. Strut the runway like a fashion plate. Let's see, navigate, percolate, propagate, save the date, syncopate, tabulate, tolerate, celebrate, educate, elevate, instigate, motivate. Today's the day we celebrate. It feels so great to ask y'all, what are we celebrating?
Celebration.
Until we